Now, you may have noticed that I didn't include ChatGPT as one of the tools for automatic glossary creation in this course. And you might be wondering why. Now, of course, it will do the trick, but there are a few reasons that I prefer other AI tools like Readwise and Notion for tapping into the artificial intelligence behind ChatGPT. First of all, the free version of ChatGPT is often overloaded. It can be almost impossible to get in. I tried forever to get into it and really couldn't. So the only option is to pay for the pro version, and ChatGPT Pro is $20 a month at the time of recording. So that's more expensive than using Notion. And you can do pretty much all of the same things with Notion and maybe even have better formatting. The output will be in an easier to use format, and it's already in a document, so you don't have to copy it out of ChatGPT and put it somewhere else. Now, in the next lesson, I'll talk to you all about confidentiality, but basically, if you are tapping into the OpenAI database or the OpenAI language learning model, then your confidentiality is much more likely to be respected because that data is not uploaded to the server, stored, and used for ChatGPT to keep learning. If you use ChatGPT, then it will learn from everything you're giving it. So, definitely much worse from a data protection and confidentiality point of view. There are a few things that ChatGPT is really good at. For example, ChatGPT writes really well in a variety of styles. If you ask ChatGPT to write like a marketing coach or to write like an enthusiastic tech geek, I may have done that, then it will produce pretty convincing texts written in that tone and style. If you tell it the style, the voice, the tone, it can draw on those and write convincingly well. But we don't need that for producing glossaries quickly. ChatGPT also, with the newest version, GPT-4, has some very neat features for analyzing images. But usually, for the purpose of creating a glossary, we aren't starting with an image. Now, there may be some interesting ways to use GPT-4 for analyzing images and labeling them and creating glossaries in the future. If so, I'll circle back and add a new lesson to this course. But basically, as far as I'm concerned, the tools that tap into OpenAI through the API, again, we don't need to worry about the details, but the tools that tap into it, like Readwise Reader and like Notion AI, are doing this directly. The developers have already thought of the use cases and taught their tools most of the prompts we need. So the results are often better, as we've seen.